saves Nekiram from his cruel competitor who was keen to cut off a pound of Nekiram's flesh.
In Agra city, there were two moneylenders. One was Nekiram. He was a decent and an honest man who never fleeced his customers and charged low interest. Nekiram would always help people out in times of need. The other was Badiram. He was a greedy man, always looking for opportunities to fleece his customers and would charge heavy interest. Most of his customers were people who were bound to him for life after borrowing small amounts from him. One day,
"Greetings, my friend."
"Kamal, what a pleasant surprise. Welcome. Please have a seat."
"Friend, I have come to you in desperate times. I urgently require a loan of 500 gold coins for a business deal and I shall repay the entire amount to you in 6 months.
I wish I could help you, my friend. Would you wait till this evening? I'm waiting for a couple of my customers to return money today."
"Sure, but like I said, I need the money today itself."
As Nekiram was a kind and helpful person, he somehow wanted to help his shadow friend Kamal. So, he tried his best to arrange some money for Kamal.
"Friend, would these 300 gold coins be enough for you now? I was able to organize only. I could give you the rest of the money by next week."
"Nekiram, I have to return to Jaipur tonight with the entire amount or all will be lost as everything of mine is at stake."
"Let me see what I can do then. Right, there's Badiram next door. I have known him for a lot of years. He too is a moneylender. I shall take a loan from him on your behalf and give it to you."
As we all know how bad Badiram was, this time Nekiram was going to enter this vicious man's door on the behalf of Kamal. Now let's see what happens next.
"My friend Kamal is here from Jaipur. I have known him since childhood. He is in desperate need of some money. I need 200 gold coins as a loan and shall give it back to you in 6 months."
"All right. Nekiram, since I know you, I will lend you the money. But there are two things though. One, the interest shall be 50 gold coins. And the second condition is that if I do not get the money back in 6 months' time along with the interest, I would want a pound of your flesh in return as compensation for the loan."
"A pound of my flesh? Oh. All right, as my friend's need is desperate, I shall accept your terms as I have full faith in him and I shall return your money on time and shall escape this penalty for non-payment."
"All right then, here are your 200 gold coins. But remember my demand. If you do not return the money in 6 months, I shall cut out a pound of your flesh in return as compensation for the loan."
"A friend in need is a friend indeed." Nekiram has proved this proverb by accepting the loan from Badiram under his brutal agreement, and all this for only his friend Kamal.
"Life is in your hands now, friend. Please ensure that you are back within 6 months with the money."
"Oh my God, what a cruel man. Don't worry, Nekiram. I shall come back with all of the money for you to pay that cruel man back. You are a true friend. Thank you so much. I shall never forget this huge favor. Goodbye, my friend."
Kendra, do you think Kamal would return with the money on time? Will Nekiram be able to pay the loan to Badiram on time? I'm curious to see what happens.
"Nekiram, your 6 months are up. Where is my money?"
"Badiram, my friend, I have just been waiting for Kamal. He hasn't arrived yet, but I'm sure he shall be here before this evening. I shall get you your money this evening. I shall surely get it to you before the sun goes down today."
"Well, you have time till sunset. Return my money or else you remember. I am going to cut out a pound of your flesh instead. Goodbye now.
Badiram, I assure you, you shall have your money. My friend won't disappoint me.
Nekiram seems to be really tense. Kamal hasn't arrived yet from Jaipur. On the other hand, Badiram is desperately waiting to get his money back. Oh, I am scared. What if Kamal doesn't return on time?
Where are you?
Badiram ji, I was on my way to see you. Kamal hasn't returned yet. I'm sure there must have been some problem. I'm sure he shall be here in a day or two. Or I shall personally travel to Jaipur and find out what's wrong. Please give me a few days extension.
No, no. I cannot afford to give you any more time. I need my money now, or according to the agreement, I shall cut out a pound of your flesh right this moment.
Badiram, have mercy on me. If you cut a pound of my flesh, I shall surely die. I shall definitely pay you back your money. I just need a little more time.
No point in pleading. Either give me the money or give me a pound of your flesh.
What's happening here? What is the problem?
Let me tell you, sir. This man here has borrowed money from me. And now he refuses to pay me my loan back or give me a pound of his flesh according to the agreement which he accepted while borrowing the money.
Is he telling the truth?
Yes, sir. He's right. I did borrow the money for a friend. My friend hasn't returned yet from Jaipur, but I have full faith in him. He shall be here soon. I just need some more time.
Why can't you give him some more time? He shall pay you interest for it.
No, sir. I refuse to wait any longer. Either he pays the money now, or I cut a pound of his flesh according to our agreement.
No, no. This man is cruel. Nekiram is a good man, and he should be given some more time. Silence. I want both of you to come to the Darbar with me. The emperor shall decide in this matter in the morning.
Nekiram and Badiram are presented in the court in front of Emperor Akbar. Minister narrates whole incident to Emperor Akbar. Emperor Akbar is known for his good idol Kaipal. The prime members of the Akbar's Navratnas, Birbal, is also present in the court.
And so I have brought them here, Your Majesty.
Birbal, why don't you handle this matter?
Your Majesty, I am Kamal, Nekiram's friend. All this trouble has been caused because of me. I got delayed while riding back to the city, but I have brought Badiram's money with me.
Badiram, you have got back your money now. I guess everything is sorted out now.
No, Your Majesty, I don't want the money now. According to the agreement, Nekiram has to allow me to cut out a pound of his flesh for not paying me the loan on time.
Why are you being so adamant? Is returning the money to you just a day late?
Your Majesty, it's about his word and our agreement. But since I'm standing in front of you, I shall relinquish my right and not cut out a pound of his flesh if he shuts down his business and leaves the city.
Your Majesty, this city is my home for long. Where shall I go after leaving the city? I couldn't do this.
My friend, all of this is because of me. You're most welcome to move into my house in Jaipur.
Wait a moment. I just don't understand this. Why are you being so adamant? Just take your money and end this matter here, right now.
Your Majesty, you are the Emperor and I shall obey your command. But that would only demean or belittle the word of a man and a business agreement. But if that's what you want, then...
Your Majesty, well, you may have a pound of Nekiram's flesh if you're so intent upon it. God, please hand over your sword. Please go ahead and cut a pound of his flesh. It's your right according to the agreement. Just one moment. Remember, according to your agreement, it's just 1 pound of flesh that you've asked for. But if you spill even one drop of blood from his body, then we shall take the same amount from yours.
But blood? But how can I do that?
How you do that is your problem. The agreement allows you to cut out only a pound of his flesh, not draw his blood. If you can do that, please go ahead.
I can't do that.
Your Majesty, this man has now given up his right to enforce his agreement.
You are a cruel man, and your intentions are very clear now. What you really wanted was to get Nekiram out of her way, as he's your competitor.
I'm sorry, Your Majesty. Please forgive me.
No, you shall not be forgiven. I have also found out that how you have been fleecing other people too. I sentence you to 1 year in prison, and the money you loaned Nekiram, he shall keep it as compensation for the anguish you have caused him. Guards, throw this man in prison.
Thank you, Your Majesty. Thank you, Raja Birbal.
Birbal, once again you have used your wit and intelligence to bring justice. Bravo. Bravo, Birbal. Bravo.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Long live Birbal! Long live Birbal! Long live Birbal! Long live Birbal!
Indeed, Birbal had a great presence of mind, and that saved Nekiram's life. No wonder, Birbal is loved after all Navratnas.